Hello, everybody, and welcome back to my YouTube and to my podcast. As you guys know, I am recording simultaneously. I am recording on YouTube and I am recording on podcast because I found out it was kind of difficult to try to do one video, then turn around and do a podcast. And so I'm just doing it together because you guys normally either want to see the video or you want to put it in your ears and listen to the podcast. So at least I can get some programs or some, you know, recordings onto the podcast. So thank you guys for joining me either or. Whatever way you guys are joining me, thank you so much for being here. Those of you that have been here, I think November is going on to my 3-year mark. And so some of you guys have been with me from the start, from the very beginning. And I am so appreciative that you found something relative. You know, some of you guys are feeling better. Some of you guys are healing great. And so you don't need the videos as much as some of the people that are coming on that are brand new to this narcissist abuse. And so those of you, you know, we're going into the holiday season. So, you know, the first holidays that are coming up is Thanksgiving. And so I wanted to make a series, you know, I wanted to make some videos and some recordings, you know, so that you can go back and listen to them whenever you start feeling a certain way. Because this is the season in which you have to prepare yourself for the holiday hoover. Now, some of you guys that have been with me from the start 2-3 years ago, we're going on to the 3-year mark. You know, you guys have made it. You know, in the very beginning, you guys were the ones that are going through this for the first time. And it's amazing because I've watched you guys go through the holidays and you made it through the holidays. You made it through Thanksgiving and Christmas. You made it through, you know, the first of the year, New Year's. You made it through Valentine's. You made it through birthdays. You made it through the reminder of your anniversaries, you know, the death of a child, the death of a loved one, or the death of the relationship. That's called grief, you know, the grief and loss process. You know, not everyone goes through a grief and loss process and losing a loved one or losing to death, but sometimes the death of a relationship, a death of your dreams, things that you have dreamed of and things that you imagine in your head. But think about it, a lot of you imagine it in your head. They didn't imagine it in their head. They didn't have anything going on in their head. They just, you know, they future fate. They presented you a beautiful picture, but they never planned to follow through with it. They had their own agendas, you know, and if things didn't work, they were going to move on to go somewhere else. They were always hunting new supplies somewhere. Now, not all narcissists cheat. Those of you know that there are some that are in the pulpits. There are some that are in ministry, you know, and not all of them because there's a certain reputation that they have to maintain. You know, so some of them do not cheat, but those are the worst relationships you can be in because they're psychologically damaging. The children are damaged. They're mean. They're hateful, you know, and yet when they go into church, you watch them pretend to be something that they're not. And so some of you guys are very baffled about that as well. Now, this part, you know, we're coming up on holidays. And so for some of you guys, you have to remember that the holiday season is the most vulnerable for a lot of you. A lot of you are very family oriented. And so, you know, you look forward to cooking and the setting up and the decorating and the family coming over. And so this is the first year where that narcissist won't be a part of the family and that you're doing this. And now you have to recreate your traditions. Traditions are created by someone and it goes through time. You know, family reunions, it's a tradition created by someone that goes through time. That's a family, you know, this you have a reason for it. You know, a lot of you guys are going to your in-laws homes. A lot of you guys are getting anxious before the season even comes up because you feel obligated to make sure that you do your duties in showing up at the family, with the family, because every year this is just something you do. Now, if you change that and you decide not to go, you know that the flying monkeys, because if you have narcissistic parent-in-laws or narcissistic parents and you got flying monkey siblings or aunts and uncles, you know, if you don't show up, you know, it doesn't matter how you feel, you should be there with the family. So if you don't show up, people have something negative to say about you. Someone's going to try to make you feel bad. I can't believe, you know, and he won't show up and he acts like he's better or she, you know, but it doesn't matter what they say. It's the fact that you need some peace of mind. You need to enjoy your holidays. You're not obligated to go to family traditional hangouts or traditional family, you know, into a place that makes you nervous, put it that way. You go into these Christmas dinners and Thanksgiving dinners, and you're going because you feel obligated to go. You feel obligated because this is a family tradition that has not been broken for many years. And if you break it, then you're the bad person, of course. But think about it. You're getting nervous just thinking about the season coming up. You're getting nervous. You hate the holidays because you know you have to deal with people that you don't like. You don't want to be around. You go to the dinner. You got people that talk out the side of their neck, if lack for better words. You have people that just say whatever they want to say. You have people that just make you feel horrible. They always have something negative to say about you and your children. They have something negative to say about you. They got to bring up things that are private. That, you know, they're messy. you know, they're messy people. So you go, or you always feel like the outcast. They make you feel, you know, unloved. You know, it's just wonderful, hateful. I'm trying to put two words together. It's just horrible. You don't want to go. Okay, but you can break tradition. Who told you that you had to keep going through with the same mess over and over again? Who said that you have to keep hating the holiday season? I love the holiday season. And if a person is gone in my life, it doesn't matter, because I'll find something wonderful to do, like watch Christmas movies. I don't really get a chance to watch a lot of TV, but when I, during the holidays, I enjoy putting up my recliner, turning on the fireplace and watching movies and walking around with my hair not done. But you know, I enjoy my peace and quiet. When you have lived a life, a lot of you have lived a life of drama, trauma, you've lived a life with this narcissist, don't forget why you left. Don't forget why you're not with the person, why you don't want to be with the person. Don't think of all the beautiful times. Think of why you're not there, why you don't want to be there. And think about the peace and quiet you have. Some of you guys in areas where it snows, enjoy the snow. Sit and just be. Watch television. Watch a movie. Watch some movies. You know, Netflix. Do the Netflix. You know, Amazon Prime. They got movies on there. TV shows, you know, come up with all sorts of movies during that season. Enjoy yourself. Cook for yourself. Cook for your children. Create a new tradition. You know, and if it's family that's involved, you just let your family know, I will not be there this year. You know you're going to hear some stuff. You know people are going to say something. You know they're going to make you feel bad. They're going to try to make you obligated to, I can't believe you're breaking family tradition. You're always making the macaroni and cheese. You're always the one cooking the turkey, whatever. Okay, well, this is the year you're going to break tradition. And this is the time that you need some peace of mind, because you don't have to be in a toxic environment. You obligate yourself to a toxic environment because that's all you're accustomed to. And some of you guys, this is your first year where your husband, your wife, your loved one, your partner is not there because you have discarded. So you have to be prepared, because this is a very vulnerable time where emotions are high. You know, if you sit around and think too long, you get all emotional. Your emotions are wide open. But you put up some safeguards. You've got to put up some guards to your heart, and don't let them start chiseling at the guard or the gates that you have put up around your heart, because all of a sudden you'll get a message. I was just checking on you. Oh, they still care. No, they don't. They're hoovering you. Or they send you some money. Here, I know that we're not together, and I know things haven't worked out the way that we planned, and I'm sorry. The apology is not a sincere apology. It's a hoover. You know, and they know that you're vulnerable, so they know that you're emotional, so they know where to get you. They're going to start saying stuff that you've been wanting them to say, that you've been longing to hear. You may get a card. I just wanted to wish you and your family. I just wanted to wish you and the kids. I just want to wish you a happy New Year's, a happy Thanksgiving, a Merry Christmas. Here's some money. You know, go buy something for yourself. Buy something nice for yourself. You deserve it. You deserve it. You're a good woman. You're a good man. You deserve it. Don't fall for that. That's a hoover. And my daughter hates when I smack. Don't fall for that. That's a hoover. Now, let's see. What else can they use? I was just checking on the children. Here's some money. Go do something for the kids. They've never done anything before, but all of a sudden they send you money. Here, do something for the kids. Here, you know, go buy some Christmas dinner. Here, go buy a turkey. You know, here. Or they just call you, hey, I'm sorry to bother you. I just want to check on you, make sure you're okay. Is there anything that you need? They've never done anything before. Or even so, it's a hoover. Remember, you got to put your guards up during the season. You know, let's see, what else? They stop by your house. Hey, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to bother you. Because some people are smooth. Some people are not, you know, some narcissists are not so aggressive. Some are real smooth. Remember, you fell in love with them. Some of them are sexy. Y'all know they look good. Six pack, 8 ounce, 40 ounce, whatever. You know, beautiful long hair. It was a wig, a weave, lashes, you know, good makeup, nice car, smell good, look good, walk good, talk good, sexy. And you guys are looking at all the aesthetics of the person, but when you unwrap that aesthetics, when you open up the package, inside is just pure evil, hateful. Remember why you left. You know, it's okay for you to suffer during the holidays. You know, I'll come on and talk to you guys. I did it before, you know, but it's okay to suffer during the holidays to get your peace of mind. Remember, even when you're pregnant, you don't stay pregnant forever. There's no way you stay pregnant forever. If you stay pregnant forever, none of us would. The population of the earth would go down drastically. You know, but you don't stay pregnant forever. And it's beautiful when you're first pregnant. And then as you get bigger, it becomes burdensome because you have to manage your weight. You can't sleep. You snore. The baby's all in your ribs. And then you give birth. And the excruciating pain is during the labor process. And when you give birth to that beautiful baby, you forget about the labor pains. Now, we remember it. We can recall it. But our body, you know, you don't feel it in your body. That's why many of you turn around and have more kids. Your body doesn't remember all that. It remembers at the time you go through it, but your body doesn't remember all that. Your mind remembers, oh, I remember it was very painful, but now you have something beautiful to look at. You look at your children and you see, I gave birth to those knuckleheads. I gave birth to those comedians. You know, I gave birth to those kids. Those are my children, and they're grown now. You're looking at them, you see your grandchildren, like, all that came from me, you know. But think about it. The same way during the holiday season, your labor pains. Go through the labor pains. You want to birth peace. You want to birth peace. You want joy, healing. Don't fall backwards. Don't fall backwards and turn around and fall for the Hoover. Now, some of you have fell for the Hoover because your emotions were wide open. That's why I tell you the relevance of getting counseling, especially during these seasons. A lot of you guys, when I opened it up and started doing coaching, I did coaching maybe like 2 years ago during this season. A lot of you called me for support during the season and you made it through. You can make it through. For some of you, this is your first time. You know, talk to the people. Some of you guys that have been on it for 2 or 3 years, I encourage you to say some things that is encouraging. Say some things and make some comments under this video at how you made it through. How you made it, because sometimes people want to see that you made it as well. And a lot of you guys that have been here with me have made it through and stayed no contact and never went back. Some of you guys did trip and fall. Some of you guys fell for the Hoover. Some of you talked, but then as soon as you talked, you knew what was going to happen. And you're like, you know what? That was a mistake on my part. And you learn from the mistake. And sometimes you got to trip and fall enough to finally figure out, okay, this is not working. The narcissist is never going to change. And they're hoovering you. Excuse me. I was eating before I got on camera. I apologize. But some of you, you know, fall for the Hoover. Some of you have fallen for the Hoover several times before you finally woke up and said, you know, enough is enough. I need peace of mind. Change traditions. Change what you do for the holidays. You don't have to keep doing the same. Who told you you had to do it? It's a family tradition. That's just what we do. I cannot break tradition because my family will dog me out. Okay, but if you have a toxic family, is it fair that you hate the holidays? Because you hate being around your family. You know, it is what it is. It is what it is. If you have a toxic family, you just can't. And then sometimes you know there are certain people that are going to be there at a certain time. You know exactly what they're going to do. You can almost time it on your watch what they're going to do. This person is about to get mad. This person is going to drink too much. This person is going to have a temper tantrum. This person wants all the attention. This person is going to cause some drama. This person is going to cause arguments. This person is going to... Some of you guys haven't even healed from the pain that your parents have caused you as narcissists. You guys haven't healed it, but you keep going into the house and you keep getting re-injured. And so it's time to change traditions. Change traditions. You create your own traditions. Create your own holidays. And even if you don't have any kids or your kids are grown, if they want to go over grandma and grandpa's house, or if they want to go over the family house, enjoy yourself. Mom or daddy going to stay at home and I'm going to sit here and drink some hot cocoa. I do not drink. Some of you guys have a glass of wine, whatever you do, and create new traditions. Do so. Decorate your house for yourself. Remember I told you a lot about fragrances, you know, aromatherapy. Get you some nice candles. I love smells. Get you some incense and nice aromas. Or my daughter taught me a long time ago, okay, this is kind of ghetto bougie, but I get Fabuloso. And I get like the Fabuloso that I like to smell. Sometimes it's like the pink one. I don't know what the pink smell is. Pink. Kool-Aid is red, the red flavor. So the pink smell. So if you get a bottle of Fabuloso, like the pink or the green apple, I love the lemon, and put it on your stove and put it on low. It's like a natural, it's like a fragrance that goes in your house and it fills your entire house. So your whole house smells like lemons, or your whole house smells like green apples, or like whatever that pink smell is, or whatever floral scent or whatever. Or some of you like just the regular old purple smell, but put it on your, put it on the stove and put it on low, like on simmer, put it on like on low. And then put the Fabuloso in a pot, or if you have like a burner that has like the fragrance burner, where you can put the oil and stuff in it, put it in there. But I like strong fragrances, and so you fill your whole house with fragrances. Some of you ladies, this is what my mentor taught us. You know, go get you some, like, I love certain colognes. I like certain colognes. Go get you a really nice expensive cologne, put it in some water, and wipe your walls with it so that your walls smell like it. Or don't go get the fragrances that remind you of the narcissist, men and women. please do not go the fragrance. Go get the fragrance that reminds you of the narcissist. That's going to trigger you and is going to mess up your holiday. Go find a fragrance that doesn't remind you of them or whoever has tormented you, and find you a nice fragrance. You know, even if it's a perfume or an expensive cologne, and spray it in a bucket or spray it on your bed. You know, create your own fragrance. You create your own ambiance in your house. If you like incense or you like the cinnamon smell of the holidays, you know, I love the smell of the burning wood and the cinnamon smell for the holidays, or peppermint. You know, go create your own ambiance in your house and relax. Go take a bubble bath. Some of you guys, men and women alike, you know, and if you big, and you don't fit in the tub, okay, well, we're going to work on that. But take you a nice bubble bath and put some fragrance in the bubble bath. You know, get some candles, light some candles. You know, woo your own self. Put some rose petals, you know, all the way to your room. Light the room up with some candles and stuff and watch you some movies. Get you a nice little drink and sit on the bed or prop your... See, we could do a girl thing. All of us girls on this channel, men, I'm sorry, I'm not a dude. But ladies, we can go get us a cabin up in the mountain somewhere, and we can just sit around with overcoming narcissist abuse, bring my mentor, my family, and us girls. We can create new traditions. Maybe we can do that one day when we finally open back up. You know, during the holidays, we go find us a good cabin, you know, a cabin with the big fire. They have like the Airbnb, and they have them right up here in the mountains where the snow is by Rainier. And we can get us a cabin, you know, the cabins that come out there where they have this giant fireplace where you could put a big crowd of people right there, and we sit around and we talk about, now you guys know you're not gonna wear me out, because we'll talk and then I'm gonna go back in my room and be by myself, shoot. But go get us a nice little cabin where we can all come together in the evening time. We can watch movies and we can drink hot cocoa. We can sit around the fireplace. We can meet each other. If somebody needs a hug, we can give out free hugs that day, you know, but we come together. But see, you create your own tradition. If you got girls that you hang with, you invite them over to your house. Create a new tradition every year. You remember Wait and Exhale? They started new traditions. You know, all of them were hurt, but they started a new tradition. They created new friendships. They were there to support each other. You have to reach out to people. Reach out to people and let's create new traditions. I want you guys to take this video and save this video to remind yourself it's okay to let go. It's okay not to involve yourself in old traditions and family traditions. It's okay. This is your first year away from the narcissist. It's going to be hard during the holiday season because your mind is going to be set on what you guys used to do. We used to go do this. We used to go do this, and we used to go visit here. We used to go every year. It was traditional for me and my narcissist. Well, it's not your narcissist, the narcissist. Me and the narcissist to go do this with the kids. We used to light the tree. We used to see, you guys do have good memories. Even though they're horrible people, you got to put aside the good memories and remember why you left. There's a reason why you left. You know, the narcissist was at home and you guys used to eat dinner, and this is what you guys used to do. And so there are fun times that you had. You know, the narcissist that I was with created fun times. There were fun times that I had with this narcissist. But at the same time, I had to remind myself how horrific this individual was and how much damage he did to me and the children. And so I maintained I would not go back. I would never go back, because I don't care about the momentary pleasure. I don't care about the momentary holidays and how wonderful I felt, and how, because I made myself feel good. I put aside all that in order for me to enjoy the holidays. And so I had to remind myself, just like you, I'm not going back. I love this freedom. I love the new me that I have become. I feel beautiful inside. I feel healed on the inside. These are the things that you have to say, even when you don't feel it. These are the things that you have to say to yourself. Walk by the mirror. You all right with me, girl? You know, or some of you brothers. Boy, you know you're sexy. You know, whether you believe it or not. You know, you encourage your own self. But you guys stay tuned. I'm going to come and talk to you guys as we get closer to the holidays. I'm going to come on live and talk to you guys during the holidays just to keep you encouraged, to keep your mind preoccupied. Now, I can't do it all the time because I do have, you know, my extended family that I tend to, and we create our own traditions. But at the same time, I'm gonna make sure that I come on like I do every year, you know, during the holidays, to come talk to you guys, to keep your, some of you guys don't even need to come on video. Some of you guys go back and watch a replay. And then some of you guys, excuse me, that are going through it for the first time, some of you guys come onto the live and I get to talk to you guys, see how you guys are doing, wish you happy holidays, just to let you know that someone is thinking about you. So once again, I always appreciate when you guys come. I want you to be encouraged and know know that somebody cares. You know, and then there are a lot of people on here. I want you guys, especially for this video, a lot of you guys have said that this will be the first time that you're going to be without that narcissist. And some of you old schoolers, you know, some of you guys that have been here for 3 years, that you guys know you went through it with me the first year, and then you guys, it got better the second year. I want you to encourage them, okay? I want you guys to say something positive to them, because you guys made it, and you know that they're going to make it. They're going to be all right. And thank you guys for tuning in. My name is Dr. Carmen Bryant, Overcoming Narcissist Abuse. You can find me on YouTube. So those of you that are on podcasts, on my Podbean, you guys can go over to my YouTube video. Over 300-400 videos on there. You can find whatever topic that you're looking for. And also, I am on Facebook. I am on Instagram. A lot of times I do come on live on Sundays on Instagram, but I do come on live on Sundays where you guys can interact with me and ask me questions. And I usually try to answer as many questions as I can, because there's so many questions, so many answers. I mean, so many questions that come on camera, sometimes I can't answer all. And some questions are really meant for coaching. And so if you're interested in coaching, you can contact me at drcarmenbryant@outlook.com. All the information is underneath my videos, Dr. and then Carmen Bryant, one word, at outlook.com. And you can email me, and I will provide you with some fees that I charge for coaching services. Those of you that are looking for counseling, I can only counsel inside the state of Washington. I am licensed inside the state of Washington, and I can only provide counseling inside the state of Washington. However, there is betterhelp.com/Dr. Carmen, which is a sponsored link. If you click on it, they provide you with a 10% discount. If you're having financial issues, let them know. They can provide you with a grant to help you pay for the fees of counselors. These are licensed counselors all through the states, even in Canada. And a lot of people have really swore by it. They have really gotten a lot of help. And sometimes you need to go to counseling before you get coaching to deal with emotional issues and learn some coping skills. And it is an outstanding program. Please go check it out. BetterHelp.com/Dr. Carmen. I do not provide counseling on that app at this time, but I do counseling within the state of Washington. And each counselor is licensed in the state that you are contacting them in. Ask them questions when you vet them. For example, don't, you know, scare them and say, do you understand narcissist abuse? Do you understand domestic violence? Do you understand emotional abuse? Do you understand a parental alienation? Do you understand complex PTSD? Do you understand the effects of severe long-term domestic violence? Do you understand that? Because it is domestic violence. And so thank you guys so much. Make sure you check out my mentor's YouTube channel. Her name is Helen Sadler, Destiny Helper. Check her out. Awesome, awesome woman, awesome mentor, and my pastor. Please go check her out. That's my spiritual parent. That's my mother. Go check her out. She provides you with insights in reference to narcissist abuse concerning biblical and spiritual principles. I usually try to stay more to the experiential clinical side, and I try to make it palatable so it's easy to understand. I try to make it pretty simple. And a lot of you guys say, I tell it like it is. I'm an old soldier. You know, I'm a retired. I'm a retired senior non-commissioned officer in the United States Army. We bottom line bluff, bottom line up front. We just tell it like it is. And I'm going to say the things that you don't want to say. And I'm going to say it how you don't want to say it, you know, but I'm going to keep it bottom line up front and tell you like it is. But I try to make it an easy conversation to articulate myself so that you guys, it's easy. It resonates easier with you. You know, you'll understand it better. And so I thank you guys so much for your support. Check out my book, Unmasking the Illusion of Perfection. You can find it on Amazon and Barnes and Noble. Those of you stocking stuffers, hey, start giving it. Some of you guys are wondering, how do I tell my family that they're probably with a narcissist? How do I tell my friends about it? Hey, all you have to do is say, hey, this is the lady that I watch. You know, I've talked to her. I've watched her. You know, this is the lady that comes on live. This is her book. Just check out the book. Guarantee you when they read it, because a lot of times we try to present people with information about narcissist abuse or narcissistic personality disorder, and you sound so clinical. We don't want to sound so over clinical, but how about we take that and we play it out to let you see what it looks like in a scenario, and some of the things, the behaviors, the things that they do, how people thought, homicidal, suicidal ideations, you know, when they're going through this, how did they end up in this? How were they groomed from childhood up? Some of the scapegoats, you know, what happened with the children? How were the children being groomed or abused? What made them leave? How, some of the stuff that they used to do in the relationship. These are real story by real people. Now, it is a Christian book, meaning that I provide Christian, what we call support, you know, meaning a Christian, how we say it, I provide biblical, like scriptures in order to comfort you. However, you have to take the principles out of the book. And many people that don't even believe in God got the book and said, I found myself in the book. And it's the principles, it's the stories that give you an idea of what it looked like to be in a relationship with a narcissist. And so check out the book, give it to people. If you don't know how to talk about it, give it to people and say, hey, this lady right here is on YouTube. You know, she's pretty cool. She likes bobbing her head. And you guys call me ghetto, I'm not ghetto. But you guys give them the book, stocking stuffers. Give it to people that are, some of the women that are in domestic violence shelter. Some of them understand the domestic violence part, but they don't understand the psychological abuse that is being, that they're going through with the people that possibly may have narcissistic personality disorder. You got to understand there are people that have the traits, you know, narcissistic traits, but there are people that actually have the disorder. And every therapist knows it's unethical for us to just diagnose people and say that they are a narcissist. You know, there's no such thing. There's a person that has narcissistic personality disorder, just like they have major depressive disorder. And so we just don't diagnose people and say, but we give you people that are on here on YouTube. You can find them on YouTube. You got people like, you know, myself. You got people like Dr. Romani. You got people like Dr. Les Carter, my mentor, or Helen Sadler, Destiny Helper. You have people on there that will give you the description of the people that have this dysfunction, how they operate, how they hurt people, you know, and it's really about how you feel. We're working more with the victims, not with the person that's perpetrating the crime, but the person that's the victim. We're telling you how you're feeling and how these people make you feel and the things that they do so you don't feel like you're crazy. But thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for supporting me. You guys make sure you like and share this video. You never know who needs to hear this, especially during this season. And I'll talk to you guys later, okay? You guys go be great.